Alright, welcome back. Finishing up with perfect competition, we need to do the long run analysis. What do we expect to have happen? Well, let's set the table for where we were before. Here was our overall, the overall market, or the full market, our supply and demand in billions of acres, in billions of bushels of corn, and here's where the price is. And for my particular firm, we look at our analysis and we see, okay, here's where we should produce, and unfortunately, we're losing money because the average total cost per unit of corn that we're producing is less than the price that we're getting for it. So what happens? What happens when you're losing money? Well, invariably what's going to happen, some farmers are going to look at this particular analysis and say, I got to get out. They quit growing corn. They start growing soybeans. They start growing cotton. They start growing, you know, bananas. You know, whatever else they can grow, they get out of the corn market. Well, what happens when enough of these people quit selling corn? What happens when the number of sellers decreases? What happens to supply and demand? Well, sellers, that's a non-price determinant of supply. Supply is going to decrease. Well, if supply decreases, our supply curve shifts to the left. Here's our new supply curve. Well, when supply shifts to the left, what happens to price? It goes up. Now you're seeing it, aren't you? So what happens to us is that all of a sudden price starts to go up because other farmers who are who are also hitting this loss right now can't pay off their loans, they can't continue to borrow money to go ahead and grow more corn, and the price of corn rises. Until all of a sudden we get a new price, which drives a new demand curve for my individual firm, and what ends up happening? Yeah. Eventually the price is going to move up to some stage where, more than likely, we're going to get to the stage where we are not making a loss anymore. And instead, we're at that stage where, for the most part, we're not making any economic profit. And why is that? Why do you not expect there to be any economic profit? What happens if the price goes too far? Let's suppose it shoots way up here and we're making an economic profit. Well, in a perfect competition, remember, it's easy to get in and out. Imagine, if you will, you're looking over at your buddy and you're a farmer and you see them making all this money at corn. What do you do next year? You switch from growing, you know, soybeans or growing wheat to growing corn. And what happens to supply? Supply grows. It shifts to the right in the overall market, and when it shifts to the right, what happens to the price? It goes back down. And so this points out one of the disturbing, or, well, just factual things about a perfect competition, is that in the long run, you're never going to have economic profit. Why? Because in the long run, people can hop in and out of the market based on whether or not they're making an economic profit or not making an economic profit. And if they're not making that economic profit and they're at a loss, they get out. And eventually the price will creep up a little bit so that you actually get to that stage where you're not making any economic profit and you're not making any economic loss. That's the long run analysis of a perfect competition. And the key is remembering the reason why you have a long run no profit is the easy entry and exit. It's easy for supply to shift left and right. Granted, it has to happen in large quantities, but it will happen when you're seeing these losses or gains. And that's what evens out the market so that there's not going to be any profit in the long run. And let's face it, I mean, if you've ever been a farmer, yeah, generally speaking, there isn't a whole lot of economic profit in it, even in the short run right now. All right. But this is the general analysis when it comes to dealing with perfect competition in the long run.